Deforestation continues at an alarming rate across the globe, the highest rates of loss centered around the equator. In 2018 alone, tropical forests lost a land area the size of the country of Belgium. This forest habitat loss and degradation poses an acute threat to the species living in these areas. Now, tropical forests are particularly biodiverse, so we as a global community have a clear goal: to quickly and accurately identify critical habitat for conservation. So we want to protect forests for threatened and endangered species, but we can't do that unless we know where they actually are. So how do we find them? Well, species adhere to the Goldilocks principle. A species can live in an ideal temperature range, but not survive if it's too hot or too cold. The Goldilocks principle applies to numerous other environmental variables as well, including precipitation, humidity, ground slope and aspect, etc. Forest-dependent species also want the canopy structure to be of a certain variety. For example, canopy height, structural variability, and a variety of tree species present. So it used to be that researchers had to physically travel to the area for which they wanted canopy structure data, and drones and airplanes would return back valuable measurements. While this returned critical habitat information, the process was expensive, time-consuming, and limited. But there's good news on the research horizon. In 2018, NASA launched JEDI, the Global Ecosystem Dynamics Investigation. JEDI is returning canopy structure data at the near global scale from the International Space Station. These data are particularly useful for dense tropical forest, for which deforestation rates are highest, field data is most limited, and biodiversity is high. My research uses JEDI data combined with JEDI canopy structure data combined with maps of climate, topography, and human impact. I combine these data sets with where I know the species to actually occur to build a model of the Goldilocks range using advanced statistics for a particular species. I repeat this process for forest-dependent tropical mammals, amphibians, and birds that are listed as threatened and endangered. We can then share these data with our partners at the United Nations Biodiversity Lab and target critical forest lands for conservation using a data-driven approach and safe